What's going on, Solid Steppers? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Ready for this poppin' Monday morning. Ready to get it in. Looking forward to having a phenomenal week. And I'm sure you feel the same way. I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this right now. This traffic be off the chain in the AM. All right, people. So, you know, I was thinking about a couple of things this morning, and one has to do with mastering. You know, you have to really reflect and see what have you mastered. You know, a lot of us are jacks of all trades and masters of none, and then we get mediocre results. And I think we have to be clear about why that happens. And the common denominator is, of course, ourselves. So what I'm recommending everybody to do is pick something that is a challenge and work on it for the next 7 days. Take your phone. This is what I do. I take my phone and I go 20-minute blocks. Like if I got to do something, since my focus sucks, I do 20-minute blocks of a task. So that means the first 20 minutes, boom. Okay, look, I'll see how much I've gotten done. And then if I have to start again, add another 20. And then the key is that you're watching your pace. And whatever you would pay attention to grows. You know, this is why you have to stay focused at all times on something of importance so that you can expand your growth as a person and as a business, as a person, business owner, partner, husband, wife, whatever role you play, mom, dad. At the end of the day, when you look at successful people, they got there by one small habit change and adjustment at a time. When you look at someone's body when they work out, that has been an effort that they've done day by day to get to that point, and then it's day by day to maintain it. That's what people don't understand. Like, whatever you want to do, you can do. You can develop and sculpt. Like, prime example, I'm working on, one of my main focuses is my workout and sculpting my body the way that I can be in the best health possible. So there's some adjustments I had to make. I had to start bringing my bands with me. And I've always had my kettlebells in there, but I wasn't applying them or taking advantage of the time I had to actually use them and work on that development. So with that said, you gotta find time. And once you find that time, you gotta make it happen. I don't care if it's 5 minutes, you gotta crunch those 5 minutes out like in the last minutes of your life, and you'd be surprised how much you grow. Like this morning, I had a number of things to get taken care of. And everything I did it like I was doing it by myself. Like I was the only person responsible. Like I didn't have subs, I didn't have anybody to depend on, no admin, nothing. I basically stepped in and do the task. And what I found out is some tasks that I asked other people to do, they did a poor job of it. So I've just shut them out. Because at this particular time, if you ask to be in a space and work with me and you don't do excellent work and you don't check behind your work, then you're sloppy and I don't have time for that. And I'm not mad with them. It's just they need to grow up somewhere else, but not on my dime or my time. And that's just business. You know, a lot of times as business owners, we'll give people tasks and things to do, and we don't inspect what we expect. So you can't get mad with nobody but you. I had to go adjust some things. I was looking at some things, and I was like, you know, this is why you don't leave stuff to other people. And it's not that I'm upset with anybody. My whole deal is, if you want excellence, you got to be excellence. You know, you have to hold yourself accountable first. So I take responsibility for the development of my business, my brand, all kind of things. And it took me no time to go in and make those adjustments myself. And then I realized that part of my problem is that because some things are easier for me because of the way my mind works, has nothing to do with my intellect and intelligence as much as it has to do with my diligence, focus, and pinpointing on what the priorities are. There are courses I'm in the middle of, I need to complete to go next level. There are a number of things I've invested in. And the grind is real. So this is why it's so important. Books like The 12-Week Year by Brian Moran, Atomic Habits a prophet first, all those books have structures in them. You know, even the book by 50 Cent, he just released one. But there's a great book by Robert Greene and 50 Cent called The 50th Law. And what people don't understand is that, I'm going to use 50 Cent as an example. When people are watching stuff like Power, Ghost, BMF, and those things, those were seeds he planted years ago. Like, he was talking about the BMF series, and he was saying how he started promoting and planted that, you know, brokered that deal basically about 10 years ago. And now it's coming to fruition. And what people don't understand is that nothing comes overnight. And a lot of us have some type of instantaneous situation going on where we want instant gratification. I mean, you guys are quick to point at the kids, but you need to be pointing at yourself in the mirror, because a lot of you guys don't have the patience to work on a craft or work on a business or work on something and to be able to take a look at the results and make it happen, you know, and adjust accordingly. And I think that's a lot of problems that people have, is because they have this idea that business is X, Y, and Z when it's not. It's a complete process. Like, prime example, I use my brother-in-law and my sister. You know, I love them to death, but I watch them in their businesses. I watch them from selling iPhones and medical supplies, all kind of stuff, you know, doing that thing. I watch my brother-in-law retire from UPS. You know, I watched so many things, and this is a young man. So the key was, he had a plan, and him and my sister stuck together with that plan, and they built something. So now they have multiple 18-wheelers on the road. They have a Turo fleet. I think they're in the process of buying a Sprinter van, and you know, and I watch how they move, and they bust their ass. You know, and they're in the middle of raising children, you know, that are going into preteens, you know, young adults. Like, there's a whole life going on over there, and challenges come with that. But I watch them stick together as a couple and grow as individuals and collectively. And my hat goes off to them. But the reason I'm saying this is they could have stopped early in. You know, they both came from interesting consequences, situations, and they came together and built something and made a commitment to, you know, build businesses and build a life and build generational wealth. And you can't knock that. But the key is, it wasn't overnight, you know? You know, my brother-in-law is very deep into taxes and, stocks and things like that. And like I say, I need to go sit down and get a lesson my damn self from him. But at the end of the day, you gotta celebrate everything around you. You gotta celebrate other people's wins, so that when yours come, you can actually enjoy it and understand the effort it took to get it. You know, I think a lot of people just aren't very clear of their path. You know, a lot of times I see my ass straying off the path, and I have to yank my own chain. I'll be like, focus, focus, focus. All right, stop that. Get back over here. You know, there are trends that come up. You know, I'm not going to say you're going to see me TikToking, because, you know, that's a different conversation. But what I'm saying is that you have to pay attention to everything going on around you, but you still have to stay focused and keep stay on the trail that you're going on. You know, a lot of our, you know, I watched Lamar, I watched Terry, I watched Slick, I watched Darian from DCNF. I watched all these guys' businesses grow. And Q, of course, my favorite. Gio, my boy. David, you know, I got a lot of respect for these guys. And I've watched their businesses because I've had an insight, I've really had a little insight into what they deal with on a daily basis because we communicate. Same thing with TMM and Brandon and at Blind's Boot Camp. I've watched these guys take their courses, develop their businesses, and do what they got to do along the way. Even with, you know, I got to give my hats off to Brandon, because, you know, the reality is, it kind of irritates me when people got something to say about a course. Now, me, I'm going to pull you by your coat strings and say, look, that's kind of raggedy. You need to handle that, you know, because I'm zero tolerance. But at the end of the day, the effort is what matters. And, you know, you got a lot of people out here not doing a damn thing, but they can critique everybody's shit. They can critique the hell. I want you to critique me so I can bust you in your head. You know what I mean? Because I can care less. But the reality is, I understand that if I don't get out here and fail, make mistakes, even with, you know, my coaching, course development, and those other things, I'm never going to get better. And so I got to give my hats off to Brandon because, you know, they had a circuit board training course and the virtual portion wasn't up to his expectations. He manned up and handled that shit. Now I got a whole nother respect for him because there's a lot of people that would have took the money and said, okay, I'll hook you up later. I'll throw you something back. No, he did what I considered the right thing. And then he did the shit publicly. And see, you got to give hats off to somebody that recognizes the errors, the mistakes, and handles it up front. And he was right to get in front of it, because if you don't get in front of it, it's going to come back and bite you. And the same people smiling in your face is the same people sharpening knives behind your back. Trust and believe. They pretend like they're celebrating with you, but they really waiting on you to fall. And it's unfortunate. This is why I move the way I move. I move so alone and so like a hermit. People be like, where is she at? It ain't got nothing to do with that. I just don't have time for the games, because you're going to end up getting cut messing with me. You know, I don't have time. You know, I'm in the middle of building my life and you know, and introducing some additional things in it. So I can't take my eyes off the ball, because it's just me. You know, I'm involved with, you know, someone that's driven as I am, and that's wonderful. But at the end of the day, she handling hers too. Trust and believe. So nobody has time for the drama. So you guys got to do what you got to do, and you got to focus on you, and you got to focus on your business, and you got to focus on your group. But you also got to understand that you are human, and you're going to fail. This is part of the learning and development process. You have to own that stuff's going to happen. I think I got time to stop by Tropic Bowl. Don't do it, Shell. Don't do it. Let me stay on task. I was about to do that swerve and get a smoothie, but today is a time-conscious day. Yep. But like I said, shout out for Brandon for handling that, because there's a lot of people that won't. There's a lot of people can't coach and train people. There's a lot of people that can't do courses, but they got something to say. But, you know, I consider them wimps, and I like to call them trolls and keyboard gangsters. But that's a different conversation. It's people I've dealt with, and they are still where they were. And then they wonder why I don't have nothing to say to them, because they ain't got no growth, no development. But they want to be inside on my game. Not no more. You ain't going to be able to peep behind the curtain. You're going to see stuff happening and don't know why. Speculate all you want, because it's my business. I have learned, put the walls up and lock the damn doors. Because it's a lot of people who are not at that level and ain't going nowhere. And I'm sorry, you can't come with me. That's what y'all like about me. I keep it real, and I'm keeping it real right now. So moving, now that we done got that out the way, we've updated the coaching links. There are some additional links in there to help you as far as structuring your business from the beginning, getting your financial house in order in reference to the business, building your business credit, several things, streamlining your business, your one-man shop, ride-alongs, along with troubleshooting, prepping for service calls, things of that nature. So with that said, I'm about to sign off, y'all, because I can see y'all cousins is already at it. The Primo's in the house this morning. And y'all have a blessed day. Like, share, and subscribe. If you have any other questions, always hit me on the email at information@solidstepstowealth.com. Talk to you later. Be blessed. Let's go get it, Solid Steppers.